In this lesson, we will understand the absorption and dispersion of light to reveal color. By the end of the video, hopefully you will be able to define absorption and dispersion of light, describe visible light and how dispersion reveals the color spectrum, and also explain why we see different colors in reference to absorption and reflection of light. In order for us to understand what color is and why we see color, we also need to have an understanding of the electromagnetic spectrum and understand what visible light is. So the electromagnetic spectrum is a range of wavelengths, and as you can see in the diagram here, there are heaps that you would be familiar with. Things like gamma rays and x-rays, ultraviolet rays, and then your FM and AM frequencies for the radio. And in the middle there is our visible light, and these are the wavelengths that can be detected by the human eye. And as you can see there, even within the visible light, each color has its own wavelength. So the reason that we can see all these different colors is because they're actually different wavelengths hitting our eye, and that picks up the different color. I really love this diagram. I think it really shows clearly why we see certain colors the way we do. So if we are seeing something as black, it's because that surface or that material is absorbing all of the different wavelengths in white light, in the visible light spectrum. So it appears black because it's actually absorbing all of the wavelengths in white light, meaning that none of the wavelengths are reflected into the eye. So that's why some people say that black's not a color, because it doesn't reflect any color into your eye. It is absorbing all of the colors effectively. The red ball we see as red because of all the colors in white light, it is absorbing all of the wavelengths except the red wavelength. So that red wavelength is reflected off the surface and it is reflected into our eye, and that is why we see that particular ball as red. The white, if we are seeing something as white, effectively that is because the surface is reflecting all of the colors in white light. So all the wavelengths in the white light are hitting the surface and all of them are being reflected back into our eye. So that is why we would see something as white. Again, that's also why some people say that white isn't a color. Essentially, it's all colors being reflected into your eye. Let's look at another example of this and the sort of experiment that you might do in a science lab in investigating color. This card here, it appears green because what's actually happening is that all of the colors in white light are being absorbed by this material except for the green part of the white light. The green part is being reflected back into our eye, so that appears to be green. Likewise, this card here, it's red. That is because this material is absorbing all colors in white light except for the red one, which is reflecting back into our eye. A way that we can actually see that this is true, so here we have the red card. If I now only allow the green to be shown through, so this time now, the light that's actually hitting this material here is only green light that's being reflected through or passing through this slide. This, well, what was a red card now appears black. And that's because red, or this material that we would think is red, is absorbing all of the green light. So in the absence of white light and the absence of the red part of white light, this card here is appearing to be black. Now if we swap those over, we would expect the same thing to happen. So here we have a green card. If we remove all the white light and only allow the red to shine through, that card now appears black. And that's because there is no green light for the card to reflect, and it is absorbing all of the red light that is being shone through it. So now I'm also going to try and show you the dispersion of light. So white light is our visible light, and visible light can be dispersed into all of the different colors of the rainbow, essentially. And so what I've got here is a glass triangular prism, And I'm going to try and get this beam of white light to actually disperse and show us the different colors of the rainbow. All right, so here, hopefully you can see, so here you've got the white light, but as it's moved through the prism, and the prism has caused it to refract, so we've got the light that's bending slightly, here we can see the different colors in that white light. So red at the top there, all the way down to the indigo here at the bottom, and you can see the green and blue in the middle, and the yellow there as well. Okay, I'll try and zoom in for you. Now, as the white light is passing through our glass triangular prism, because of the different wavelengths and the different colors of visible light, the violet light travels slower through the glass than what the red light does. And that is what is causing it to split and to disperse, showing us that rainbow of colors there.